Today's topic, how TikTok is ruining your relationship. Oh, you will hate me in the middle of this episode, but at the end of it, if you listen to it till the very end, then this has the potential to change your relationship, at least if you are on TikTok, and especially if you're spending a lot of time on TikTok. And this is a topic that I know will not turn you into somebody who says, oh, Sebastian, I like you. Because when we are addicted to something, then we often don't want to hear it, basically. When somebody says, hey, you might have a problem with that, your ego goes, no, that's not true. Not at all. That's not true. That's a lie. But in my experience as a dating coach, both for men and for women, I experience it more and more and more that women tell me how their boyfriend complain about their use of TikTok, especially younger women, and how guys actually book coaching sessions with me just because they are so fed up with TikTok and their relationships are going downhill because of TikTok. I mean, a lot of guys I talked about this topic, they actually told me that they consider breaking up with their girlfriend because of TikTok. And if you are in a relationship right now, especially if you are a younger woman, but there are also a lot of women who are over 30, over 40 and over 50 who are on TikTok, this might be the warning that you need in order to rescue your relationship. And I really mean this. If you, for example, look on Reddit, there is post after post after post of guys who say, I can't deal with it anymore. I'm gonna go crazy. I have to break up with her even though I love her. And I don't want your relationship to end or at least to suffer just because of a stupid app. And the first thing that I want to share with you when it comes to TikTok is that harmless pranks can often turn into hurtful pranks. I mean, if you, for example, prank your boyfriend on TikTok and you say, hey, whoa, boo, and he's scared a little bit and goes, oh, what the hell are you doing? I mean, that's funny. That's okay. That's playful. But if you, for example, do what a lot of women on TikTok do, and you can find these compilations on YouTube, you can find them, of course, on TikTok. Let's say when the guy sits in the car and they pretend to go out of the car to take a call, and then they say, oh, he's not the father of the child. And then you see the guy in the car going, what? What? I'm not the father? And he starts crying. Or they make those stupid pranks of like, hey, you know, we need to talk. I'm going to break up with you. And then the guy is crying, all the emotions come up, and then she says, oh, it's just a prank, it's just for TikTok. And this inevitably leads to a distortion between reality and fiction. At some point, your boyfriend, if you do that, will no longer be able to distinguish reality from fiction. And if you then really have to talk about something, if you really have to work through an issue, if there's really something that bothers you in the relationship, he won't take you seriously anymore. Because no matter what you do, he will think, oh, it's just a prank, it's just for TikTok. Or, is it? Is it a prank? Is it real? What's going on? And this often happens when couples do these stupid breakup pranks. When then in the end, when there's really an issue, the other partner doesn't believe anymore. And he goes like, what? No. I mean, hey, I thought it's just a prank. What are you talking about? And then they are shocked when the relationship ends. Because they think, oh, it's just one big prank. And if you spend more time watching random people on TikTok than talking with your boyfriend, who you love, then your relationship will inevitably suffer. And this is one of the most common complaints of young guys, that even when they spend time with their girlfriends, that all their girlfriends do is be on TikTok, like a video, scroll, show him their TikTok stuff, and there's no connection, there's no quality time, there's nothing. And this is a relationship development that I see that's very, very frightening, to be honest, where couples, especially younger couples, sit in a restaurant or sit together at home and either both of them, or when it comes to TikTok, it's most of the time women. I mean, that's just how it is from my experience as a dating coach. Most of the complaints come from men when it comes to women using TikTok, because the app is designed to make women more addicted. If you really look at the marketing and how the whole thing works, it's designed, of course, for both men and women to be addictive, but because TikTok is more about playfulness, about fun, about dancing, it's like a drug for women. And a lot of men told me, a lot of younger guys told me, that they feel really, really bad, which is totally understandable, when their girlfriend spends more time on TikTok when she's with them than cuddling with him or talking to him. And sometimes even when they say, yeah, my girlfriend cuddles with me, but she cuddles with me with her smartphone in her hand, watching TikTok videos. And if you are at this point right now where your boyfriend shows you clearly that he's fed up with your behavior in case you watch a lot of TikTok, then you can still rescue the relationship. And if you want to find out how you can make a guy who might even has lost interest in you devoted again, then you can click on the link in the description, watch this video till the very end and use the devotion sequence on him. But even if you use the knowledge that you discover, if you click on the link in the description and watch this video, still think about whether or not you spend more time with your boyfriend or you spend more time with your smartphone. And your boyfriend will develop the "are you filming this" paranoia. And this is very, very important. If you, for example, are so obsessed with TikTok that every emotional reaction you get out of him should be filmed, this will destroy your relationship, I promise you. I've talked to guys about that, and in the end, they all came to the conclusion that they want to end the relationship. If, for example, he doesn't know if you say "I love you" because you mean it or because the camera is rolling somewhere, this will freak him out. And there are so many videos of women on TikTok where they try to get an emotional response from their boyfriend, and they just do it for the camera. And if I put myself in this position, I have to be honest, if I put myself in this position where my girlfriend tells me how much she loves me, and I tell her the same, and the moment I say it, she then takes the camera, or let's say the smartphone with the camera that was hidden somewhere behind the pillows, and uploads it on TikTok, that would be an emotional betrayal for me. And a lot of guys see it the same. And you risk ruin private emotional moments. I mean, one of the stories that really shocked me was when one of my male coaching clients told me that in one instance, he was expressing his emotions to his girlfriend and he was giving her, I think he was giving her a gift if I remember it correctly, but he was basically telling her how much she means to him and how much he loves her. And all his girlfriend did was to ask him, "Oh, can you say it again?" And then she was putting the camera in his face. And he told me that this was the most painful moment in his relationship, while she was all giggly and thinking, "Oh yay, I can show my fans and followers how amazing my boyfriend is." You risk ruin every private emotional moment if you film everything. And even if you don't film everything, at some point, like I said, your boyfriend might develop this paranoia that, is there a camera? Does she just do that because she wants to show off on TikTok? I mean, in case you are a lot on TikTok and you do these things and you feel triggered right now, you feel offended and you want to punch me in the face, then put yourself in his shoes. Just imagine your boyfriend tells you how much he loves you and then he immediately takes a smartphone and says, "Oh, please, can I record your reaction? I want to show my fans what's going on." You would also feel betrayed. And you communicate to your boyfriend by doing that, that your random followers who you've never met, who don't really care about you, are more important than him, and this hurts. And this is addictive. I mean, those apps, especially TikTok, are designed to make you addicted to it. And your addiction can in fact destroy your relationship, just like any other addiction. And it has become an addiction when you can no longer control it, when you can no longer live without it. So if you spend a lot of time on TikTok, I challenge you to spend 1 week without TikTok. Go cold turkey without any TikTok 1 week and then see how your body and your mind reacts, because social media apps are designed to make you addicted. And we human beings are biologically programmed to want attention, and all these likes and all these comments and all these followers give you attention, but they give you fake attention, they give you fake affection. Not one of your followers would be there for you when you get sick. Your boyfriend will. So always keep in mind what's more important: fake likes on TikTok or the real relationship that you have with your boyfriend and that you might be destroying by being obsessed with TikTok. And no matter if it's because of TikTok or because of any other relationship issue you're facing right now, or maybe because you want to finally meet the man of your dreams, you can talk to me about it. I can help you. I've coached so many amazing women and I know that I can also help you. If you want to find out more about Skype coaching with me, you can click on the second link in the description. And if you enjoyed watching this video, if you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up and leave a comment in the comment section below. Share your opinion, share your thoughts. I would love to hear from you. And I would love it even more if you would hit the subscribe button and smash that notification bell so that you get notified whenever I release a new video for you. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video.